Today we are going to see zero of the polynomial. It is a very, very important concept in the polynomials. So we'll start with some examples. We know what is a polynomial. We already discussed. So P of x is my polynomial. And it is defined like this, some x square minus 2. This is my polynomial in one variable, x with second degree. This is also, we called it as quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. See here, in this polynomial will be changed by values of x. Suppose if I take x values 1, the p of 1 will be 1 square minus 2, that equals to 1 minus 2, because 1 square is nothing but a 1, 1 minus 2 is equals to minus 1. This is the values of polynomial when x is replaced by 1. If we take f is equals to 2, we get 2 square minus 2, that is equals to 4 minus 2, that is equals to 2. So if you are keeping x is equals to 3, yeah, if you take x is equal to 1, x is equal to 2, or x is equal to 3, we'll see p of x will be changed. P of x is equal to x square minus 2. When we substitute x is equals to 3, x is equals to 3, we get 3 square minus 2, that is equal to 9 minus 2, that is equals to 7. So you keep on giving the values for x, the p of x values will be changed. Accordingly, x values. Suppose if I take x is equals to root 2. So therefore, p of x is equals to, we know, x square minus 2. So in place of x, if I take p of x is equal to root 2, I will get root 2 whole square minus 2. So by cancel out by square and square root, this is square root and square, we get 2 minus 2, that is equals to 0. So we are giving so many values, but one value for one x value, p of x is equals to 0. For one x value, p of x is 0, yet x is equals to root 2. So this is called zero of the polynomial. See, in general, we can say zero of the polynomial p of x is the value of x, is the value of x for which p of x equals to zero. Suppose if I take some other example. Suppose if I take p of x is equals to 2x minus 1. This is my polynomial. If I giving x values 1, 2, 3 and so on, p of x values will be changed. P of 1 is equal to 2 times 1 minus 1, 2 minus 1, that is equals to 1. If we take p of 2, 2 times 2 minus 1, 2 to the 4 minus 1, that is equal to 3. So keep on giving these values, we'll get some values. But when we get p of x is equals to 0, this is so complicated by trial and error to get the 0 of the polynomial. Therefore, I would like to do it like this. If p of x is equal to 0, 2x minus 1 must be equals to 0. Then 2x is equals to positive 1, because when transpose this one positive 1. Then x is equals to 1 by 2, because here 2 is multiplying, will go this side, it divides. When x is equals to 1 by 2, when x is equal to 1 by 2, here p of x I define 2x minus 1 when x is equals to 1 by 2. That x is equal to 1 by 2. In place of x, I will get 1 by 2. In place of x, 2 get cancelled and minus 1. Here we have minus 1, right? Therefore, 1 minus 1 that is equal to 0. See here how short we can find 0 of the polynomial. So here 1 by 2 is a 0 of polynomial. Very, very important concept. In general, we can say, in general, I would like to highlight that. Okay. So in general, we can say, we can say that 0 of the polynomial p of x is the value of x for p of x is equals to 0. Therefore, here 1 by 2 is the 0 of this polynomial. We already taken one more example, that is p of x is equal to x square minus 2. Then we take an x is equal to root 2, then we get 0. So by placing the values x is equal to 1, 2 and 3, it is taking lot of time to find the value of or 0 of the polynomial. So to get the 0 of the polynomial, very shortly we can get it. Here p of x is equals to x square minus 2. Therefore, p of x is equals to 0 by definition, we get x square minus 2 is equal to 0, then x square is equals to 2. Then x is equal to root over 2. When you remove the square, you can keep it here, square root in the other hand. Here you should keep plus or minus, because when any number in the root, it have two values, that is plus or minus, keep in mind every time. Suppose if I have inside square root inside we have 4, we can write 2 times 2, 1 2 goes out, that 2 is the square root of 4. That is also we can write minus 2 times minus 2, minus into minus plus, 2 2 is 4. Therefore 1 minus 2 goes out from the root. So minus 2 is the root of again positive 4. That the reason we will get positive 2, 2 and negative 2. Similarly, here x square is equal to 2, then x is equal to plus or minus root 2. This is very, very important. So when I take x is equal to plus root 2, we get the 0. See here, p of root 2. We can take here root 2 in place of x square minus 2. Square and square root get cancelled. We get 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. That's the reason 2 root 2 is the 0 of the polynomial. Even if you take x is equal to minus root 2, we get 0, because p of minus root 2, right, root 2 is equals to minus root 2 all square minus 2. Yes, by squaring on it, the minus will becomes positive, because minus root 2 times minus root 2, minus into minus plus, root 2 into root 4 is nothing but 2. Yeah, so this and this get cancelled in shortcut. We can write it down 2 minus 2, that is equals to 0. Now, every time keep in mind, if you want to find the 0 of the polynomial, very simple we can find. Without substituting x values or y values or z values, depends upon our polynomial. Suppose if I have some p of x is equals to some x square plus 2x plus 1, you no need to placing the x values to get the 0 of the polynomial. Very simple, I told you clearly, p of x is equal to 0, we get zeros of polynomial. So here x square plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. This is, we can write x plus 1 whole square is equal to 0. How we can write x plus 1 whole square? Maybe we get it out. See here, I told you in the previous class, a plus b whole square is always equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. This is a beautiful algebraic identity. you take x plus 1 whole square, we can write x square plus 2 into x into 1 plus 1 square. See, a square plus b square plus 2ab, we can write anyway, nothing will happen. So x square plus 2 1 jar 2x plus 1, see, my polynomial like this only. See, this is, we can write x plus 1 whole square equal to 0. Then x plus 1 is also 0, x is equals to minus 1. Try it, if you take x is equal to minus 1 in this polynomial, it is no doubt that it is equal to 0. See, p of minus 1 we take in. So minus 1 whole square plus 2 times minus 1 plus 1. So minus 1 whole square is nothing but positive 1. 2 1 jar 2, but here plus and minus, so minus 2 plus 1, that gives 0. See how to find the zeros of the polynomial. This is very, very important. Keep in mind, to find the zeros of the polynomial, take the polynomial and equate with 0 to get the 0 of the polynomial directly.